How you do that? How exactly can you tell when a leader is practicing injustice? How you think? How can you determine that? How should we define injustice? Going back to the prophet Micah, he helps us understand this much better. Give me Micah 3, verse 1 and 2 again. See, the prophet gives us a very simple way to look at it. Someone got that?
Come on. Look at Micah chapter 3, verse 1. And I said, "Hear, I pray you, O heads of Jacob."
Now he's talking about the leaders. He said, "O heads of Jacob," read on.
"And ye princes of the house of Israel."
All leaders, guy.
"Is it not for you to know judgment?"
So he's saying, you're supposed to know how to judge people, man. You're in charge of people. Aren't you? That's a rhetorical question, huh? He doesn't want to answer. He's saying, man, you're supposed to know how to judge people. Read on.
Verse 2. "Who hate the good and love the evil."
He said, you hate the good, but you love the evil. You hate the good, but you love the evil. So Micah is telling us how to judge injustice. How do we know them? Because they hate the good. They hate what's right, but they love wrong. They love evil. They love evil, man. That's heavy, man.
Cool.
So that could be a problem when any of us think of it this way, right? Especially somebody in authority. See, it's bad enough when the average man acts unjustly. Average woman acts unjustly. But when people in positions of power and authority, well, in positions of influence, when they do it, that's like devil evil. And so that's why Micah asks, see, that's he's asking rhetorically, right? "Is it not for you to know justice?" That's what he's asking in verse 1. He said, yo, man, you're supposed to know justice. He said, don't you heads and you rulers need to concern yourselves with justice? This is what we're saying to the court systems. This is what we're saying to all you lukewarm preachers and priests and rabbis. Well, see, it's very unthinkable that they would be in these positions of powers and they're not enforcing justice. Stop me where I'm lying at. Leaders literally set the pace for the remainder of society. Is that true or not? Leaders yes. literally set the pace for the remainder of society.
Fast. Fast.
A rabbi, a pastor, they set the pace. A priest, they set the pace for the remainder of the church. So if they themselves act as if they are above justice, then who do the people turn to? How would people find protection from those who are dishonest? See, I'm going somewhere with this, man. I want you guys to muse over this. How would they find safety from those wishing to exploit them by greed? How would the weak be watched? How would the weak be watched over from those wishing to do them harm? See, the Most High established an order. That's what I'm getting to. Yahuwah established an order. You got government, you got leaders. And this is why the words are such an indictment. Use the word you. Don't you need to know justice? See, on the contrary, he said, you hate good and you love evil. You hate good and you love evil. There's nothing worse that could be said than that. See, that's the height of iniquity. It's to hate what Yahuwah loves. You don't get any worse than that, man. You hate what the Most High loves. And you love what the Most High hates. See, the Most High gave you an order, woman. You hate that thing. That's why you don't do it. You're a hypocrite. Go to Micah chapter 3, read verse 2 and 3. Micah, son, why don't you practice justice? He said, you tear the skin off of my people. Boy, that's a horrific way of explaining something, man.
Right.
Can you imagine having your skin pulled from your body like an animal? How many of you ever seen them clean like an animal they capture out of the forest? I seen my grandfather do it once. Just pull the skin off of it, man. Skin it.
God, damn.
Down to the meat.
Them skin them cows. Come on, it's a simple statement in the beginning, but it's so profound when you really think about it. Look at Micah chapter 3, verse 2. Who hate the good and love the evil, who pluck off their skin from off them and their flesh from off their bones.
That thing is heavy, man. Read on.
Who also eat the flesh of my people and flay their skin from off them, and they break their bones and chop them in pieces as for the pot and as flesh within the cauldron.
Well, that thing is heavy, man. Well, when you first read that, that might offend you consciously, man. But you know where they probably do? Because you don't love justice. You don't love justice as much as you think you do. Maybe you haven't suffered enough. Maybe you haven't suffered quite as others, man. See, these leaders, they're not literally doing these things that he's explaining right here. Those are metaphors. Well, they're not eating the people. That's metaphorically. Well, but the language is for emphasis and the stress. He wants it to be memorial, well, so you can remember it. Basically, what he's saying injustice is tearing the skin off of my people. And you're staring it in a pot so that it could be eaten. See, that's graphic, man. That's disgusting. It's alarming. It's unthinkable. That's the message that the Most High want to project, that these people are doing unthinkable things. That's how you're supposed to see injustice, man. See what's going on, man. You know what the problem is? These leaders are trying to be fair instead of just. See, what Micah is describing is what it's like for you being a husband of a damn reviling wife. That's what he's describing. That's what it's like being a husband of a reviling wife. Why? Because a wife is not held accountable for her sins. See, many of these preachers, these rabbis, these pastors, these priests, they can mistakenly think that if the wife is sin, what has the husband done? The cause of the sin. Hey, buddy, all right? Don't tell me you guys haven't met something like this, man.
Oh, yeah.